So let's look at what language we use when we want to talk about different weights or different measures. Typically, we measure or we put things into certain containers and or in certain formats. So let's have a look what are the most common in Spanish. So we have here una bolsa, okay? Una bolsa, and specifically una bolsa de patatas fritas. Una bolsa de patatas fritas. You remember, patatas fritas, chips or crisps. We also have un bote, and in this case, un bote de mermelada. Un bote de mermelada. También tenemos, we also have, también tenemos una caja. And this could be una caja de zapatos, a shoebox, una caja. We also have, un cartón, although I don't really like this this word. Okay, I think the most common in Spanish is un brick or un tetrabrick, okay? Un cartón o un brick o un tetrabrick. In this case, de leche, a milk carton. Y también tenemos, we also have, también tenemos una lata de Coca-Cola. O una lata de atún, tuna. Notice how in Spanish we don't have a tin and a can. Everything is the same. Una lata, okay? También tenemos esto. Esto es una barra de pan, una barra de pan. Y esto es un trozo o un pedazo, ¿ok? This is la barra, una barra, and a piece es un trozo o un pedazo. Esto es un vaso, ¿ok? Y puede ser un vaso de agua, por ejemplo. Y esto es una botella. Y puede ser una botella de agua, una botella de vino, etc. Esto es, esto es un poco de sal, un poco de sal, a bit of salt, okay, un poco de sal. Y esto es una ración de gambas. Una ración. ¿Vale? Una ración. So we have una bolsa, un bote, una caja, un cartón o brick o tetrabrick, una lata, una barra, un trozo o un pedazo, un vaso, una botella, un poco y una ración. Okay, so lots of different lots of different ways how we package or how we serve things. Let's now finally to finish with, let's have a look at some verbs which will typically be associated with measures. Okay, the most important one is medir. Medir, to measure. And I can say things like mido, for example, mido un metro, mido un metro y 70 centímetros. Mido un metro y 70 centímetros. Notice that in Spanish we always measure things in centimeters, meters, kilometers, that sort of thing. Okay, we don't use imperial measures. It's everything is the metric system. So medir, mido. If someone else measures something, mide 3 metros. It is 3 meters long. Okay, so it's a pretty much regular. Verb medir, to measure. We also have the verb pesar, to weigh. Pesar. So, for example, I could say peso 70 kilos. Peso 70 kilos. And notice again, in Spanish we also measure in kilos or in gramos, okay, kilograms and grams. We also have another interesting verb, which is bastar. Bastar is to be enough. So I could say, for example, basta una caja. One box is enough, okay? Basta una caja. I don't know, para hacer un pastel. I could have, I don't know, a box of something, let's say a box of, baking powder. I mean, that would be a lot of baking powder for a cake. But okay, my point is, bastar is to be enough. And then we've also, the final verb is alcanzar. Alcanzar is literally to reach, okay? But in this case is in the case of measures, it's more applied to things like to stretch out. Okay, I think you could say stretch out. So for example, I could say el pescado no alcanzó para todos. Okay, the fish didn't stretch out for everyone. It wasn't enough for everyone. Okay, it didn't, literally didn't reach for everyone, but basically it didn't get shared amongst everyone. I could also say el dinero no alcanza para unas vacaciones en la playa. Okay, the money is not enough. The money doesn't reach or doesn't stretch out to some beach holidays. Okay, so three interesting verbs: medir, pesar, bastar, and alcanzar, that are going to help us talk about measures. Okay.